Dan Illman, Mike Beer, superstar Sister Charlie returns in race number 3 at Saratoga on Saturday. It's the Grade 2 Ballston Spa going a mile and a 16th on the inner turf. Before we get to the analysis, let me remind you to please visit the Saratoga landing page. DRF.com/spa is where you go for PPs, picks, clocker reports, betting strategies, and lots, lots more. It's the Saratoga handicapping shop with the must-have tools to win big at Saratoga. Here's the field for the Grade 2 Ballston Spa. Not too many excited to line up against Sister Charlie, Mike. 2-5 on the morning line, but I guess they're always a little bit vulnerable coming off a long layoff, even with Chad Brown manning the controls.
I guess we'll see. She sort of towers over this field on form, Dan, and 2-5 is probably being generous on the morning line.
Let's take a look at the time form U.S. pace projector for this race. Big, long shot. North Broadway is expected to make the front. There's not a ton of speed in here. You know, if I was Javier on Starship Jubilee, I would go. Considering the form Starship Jubilee is in and you're catching the big favorite off of a layoff, maybe the best tactic for Starship Jubilee would be to try to open up and hold on.
Yep, I agree with you, Dan. If she was my horse, I would just put her on the front in this race and see what happens.
The number one, Call Me Love, is a multiple group stakes winner in Italy. She has raced twice in the United States for Christophe Clement. I thought she had good trips both times. In the Bogey, she chased Rushing Fall. Rushing Fall is just better than she is. And last time out in the New York, she chased Mean Mary. And Mean Mary might be better than she is. That was a race where the third place finisher came back to run third in the Matchmaker with a 91 buyer speed figure down at Monmouth. I think Call Me Love is going to get another good trip in here, breaking from the inside post. She just catches another tough one. But she does have recency.
She does. I guess we'll just see how good she is, Dan. She did come over here with a couple of group wins in Italy. I don't know what that means, really. Personally, I haven't really been thrilled with either of her two races over here. I know she was second to Rushing Fall in the Bogey, but to me, she just sucked up and got second in that race without doing a ton of running. And she was no match last time going longer. They're going to cut her back here. We'll see if that works.
Bramble Queen has won 3 of her last 4 turf starts for trainer Mike Deeney. This is an Illinois bred who scored last time out at Delaware Park going a 2-turn 7.5. Let's watch that race right now. She was coming off of a big priced win when dangled for a $32,000 tag. Here, Bramble Queen got a fast pace and she was able to rally it down. Pace might be different and the class of horse she's facing a lot different.
Right. Not the best closer in this race by any stretch of the imagination. It just looks like a race that she can't possibly win.
North Broadway, trained by Chad Brown. And I wonder if Chad has her in here maybe to ensure a decent enough pace for Sister Charlie. She was a winner 2 starts back at Gulfstream in a maiden race. And then she was beaten at 4-5 in an entry level allowance by a decent enough runner. That Kathleen O'Connell horse, Queen's Embrace, came back to run a good third in the Lake Placid with an 82 buyer. On paper, she can't win. It makes me wonder, is this the rabbit?
Yeah, it feels like she was either in here to provide some pace for Sister Charlie, or you know what? There's only 5 entered for turf day. Maybe she was just entered to make the race go. We'll see what happens. Either way, she's not a horse that you're going to be betting money to win on, that's for sure.
Another broad, the number 4, has entered main track only, and she must be considered if this race is washed off, but we will move to Sister Charlie. 10 of 15 in her career, $3.6 million in lifetime earnings. She runs well fresh. We'll watch her loss last year in the Breeders' Cup Filly and Mare Turf. She ran just fine. She's on the outside in the green silk. She had to go 4 wide on the turn, and she's going to finish a solid third. If she runs any of her races, she's going to be real tough. Just look at all those triple digit buyers. There really isn't much to say. Her form speaks for itself.
Yeah, she's just a really, really, really good horse. Just look at her resume, Dan. A Jenny Wiley, 2 Dianas, 2 Beverly D's, a Flower Bowl, a Breeders' Cup. She's won every major race for this Filly Mare Turf division that's out there. She's won off the layoff each of the last 2 years. She won off the layoff 2 years ago in the Jenny Wiley over this distance. She's just way the horse to be, and it's going to be surprising if she loses.
Kevin Attard, though, has done a stupendous job with the 6 Starship Jubilee. She has won 5 of her last 6 races, 3 in a row. One of those races, the Grade 1 E.P. Taylor, 17-time winner. Not bad for a horse that was claimed away from Jorge Navarro for $16,000. back in 2017. Let's watch Starship Jubilee take care of business in the Grade 2 Hillsborough back in early March at Tampa Bay. This race has not come back very strong. She had them over a barrel coming in. I like that she was able to rally and win. She's a solid horse, and if the favorite stubs her toe, I guess she is the most likely alternative.
Yeah, if Sister Charlie does not win this race, then it seems pretty certain that Starship Jubilee will be the horse that takes her down. She's been an amazing claim, was in really good form the last time we saw her. And as you mentioned in the open, Dan, she has tactical speed. I mean, they should just put her on the lead here and see if they're catching Sister Charlie at the right time.
Let's take a look at our top picks for the Grade 2 Ballston Spa Stakes. No show wagering available due to the presence of the heavy favorite Sister Charlie. And that's where we go. 5, 6, 1, 2. There is super wagering. We got the same soup.
Yeah, I mean, we'll see how it all plays out. Then I'm not going to have a nickel in against Sister Charlie, though.
Sister Charlie back to the races, and it's good to see. Let's see if she comes through in the Grade 2 Ballston Spa. Race number 3 at Saratoga on Saturday is an approximate post time of 2:18 Eastern. Best of luck.